The capacity crowd of better than 16,300 here at the MGM Grand Garden, anxiously awaiting the main event. The anticipation builds as the countdown continues. And finally, we're just moments away from the opening bell. Well, postponements have jeopardized Holyfield-Tyson fights over the years to the point where many of us wondered if we'd ever really be here tonight. It all goes back to their ill-fated 1991 fight. So when Tyson announced he'd suffered a cut over his left eye in sparring to postpone the original May 3rd rematch date, many said, uh-oh, we may never see these guys fight again. But despite the history of postponements, there has always been a feeling of inevitability, an aura of fate that finally brought them together. And now brings them together again, maybe for the last time, maybe not. We bring back the fight doctor. What's at stake here for Tyson, aside from the obvious, the heavyweight title?
I think the rest of his life is at stake. If he loses here, he loses that edge of being a great fighter or the possibility of joining the great heavyweights and becomes just another one of those heavyweights that didn't quite arrive at greatness. And of course, for him, he has no other recourse but to fight. So it's an extremely important fight for his lifestyle, for his mental conditioning, and what he's going to do. As far as Evander Holyfield is concerned, his is already done. He's already up there, and if he wins again, he secures his place, and if he doesn't, he's still a great champion. But more so, he has faith, he has other business interests, and he has a life. He has a life to go to. Tyson does not. Tyson must win.
And Bobby Chez, what changes does Tyson have to make to get his redemption? And does Holyfield even have to make any changes after his successful game plan of the first fight?
Well, Holyfield certainly does not have to make too many changes. He sat inside the eye of the storm where he needed to. Got inside Mike's big stuff, made him pay on the inside, punished him. On the win, used the jab. He counterclockwise walked him around the ring, tying up his left hand, pushing away from his strength. He did all the right things. He rolled with punches. He countered back. He made Mike get tired. Now on the other side of that coin, Mike has a lot of adjustments to make. He's got to get back to double, triple jab behind the bobbing of the head. He stopped moving his head and became a stationary target for Evander Holyfield. And he's got to work the body and come up with combinations. No more one haymaker at a time looking for the home run shot. It just won't work this time.
Bobby, is Tyson capable of making changes at this point of his career?
Well, he's already made some changes. He changed Jay Bright, and he brought in Rich Cicchetti. They have a relationship. They have a history. He's making the changes. He has a different corner. I'm sure he's made the adjustments in training. He's at the lightest weight he's been in 10 years. I'll tell you what, he's good.
How about leading us into some key highlights?
Okay, we'll take a look at some of the things from the first fight, some of the key points. What you're looking at here, watch Evander Holyfield grab Mike Tyson and walk him around. He ties him up. He grabs that arm. He walks him counterclockwise. He doesn't allow Mike to stop, plant his feet, and use that left hook and bang him on the inside. And he pushes him back. Mike Tyson cannot fight going backwards. This is what Evander did all night long. Mike got inside, tied up that left hand, Mike's big bomb, big weapon, and walked him around. Now, he also countered back. Watch him roll his head as he fires back. Mike's going to throw a right hand. He'll roll with it, fire right back, bang. Roll with the shot, fire back, counter. Make Mike pay. He did that every time, each and every time. Now you watch here, when he doesn't tie Mike up, look, both hands are staying up in a clinch. Mike, his hands are free, he doesn't push Mike back. He digs to the body, and he digs with the uppercut. That hurt Evander, that's probably the most he was hurt in that entire fight. He can't allow that, but that's what Mike has to do.
All right, some final thoughts before the ring walks. Going into the first fight, almost everybody expected so little. Remember how we thought, hey, maybe Holyfield will at least be game. Maybe he'll last a few rounds before Tyson rips him apart. But then round by stirring round, Holyfield took Tyson apart. He exposed a one-dimensional attack. Not only did most of the so-called experts underestimate Holyfield, but so did Tyson. He underestimated Holyfield's strength, chin, boxing ability, courage, and will to win. Tyson admittedly tried to obliterate Holyfield quickly, anticipating the home run punch as his saving grace, but Holyfield's heroics made many of you want to believe again, just like he believed. He showed how powerful the human spirit can be. Yes, for countless people, it was the feel-good event of the year. But now, going into the second fight, nobody really knows what to expect. We're entering the great unknown. But while the first fight was famous for its shocking upset, one thing is known. The rematch could produce the greatest heavyweight of his generation. How does history figure in? It's Holyfield's third rematch. He made it two straight over Alex Stewart within 4 years. After losing the undisputed world heavyweight belt to Riddick Bowe, he regained the WBA IBF titles from Bowe, but then lost to Bowe again in that third meeting in an untitled bout. Meanwhile, 7 years separated. Tyson's first fight and rematch victories over Frank Bruno, the latter for the WBC crown, but it took only 3 months for Tyson to win back-to-back fights with Razor Ruddock. Overall, in 24 World Heavyweight Championship rematches, the champion has won 17 times, the challenger 6, one draw. History dramatically on the side of Holyfield. We're awaiting the ring walk of Mike Tyson. There is the door to his dressing room. He'll be in the uncharacteristic position as challenger, coming in first, the former undisputed heavyweight champion and the youngest champion in heavyweight history. Bobby Chez, should we look to the first round as being critical for telltale signs?
I think the first round is going to be critical for a lot of things. If Evander Holyfield can establish the jab and push Mike back once again, we may have a rerun. If Mike starts being effective to the body, throwing combinations and wearing down Holyfield in the early going, we will look at revenge.
Ferdy, do you think Tyson's going to come out in furious fashion?
I do. I think he's got the one-punch knockout, whereas Evander has to wear you out, so he's looking to get out of there fast. Right now, getting out of the dressing room is the main thing, whether he was going to play the game or not, and he's not. He's coming out, so he's not going to play that sight game.
Led by Richie Giacchetti, his returning trainer. Here comes Mike Tyson, and the crowd erupts here in the arena. He's trying to win the heavyweight title for a third time to emulate Muhammad Ali and Evander Holyfield. As usual, no robe, just the cutout towel, no socks. But a mystique, a cloak of invincibility that is tenuous, predicts, in his words, a sensational victory, looking for the early knockout, but says if a decision comes, he'll take that too. Tyson said he can't conceive of himself losing. But in contradiction, he also says there is some doubt. The reported cut over the left eye sustained in training, which postponed the original May 3rd date, said to be of no consequence now. He claims he's 100% ready physically and mentally, saying, quote, if Holyfield wins, he'll beat me at my best. Bobby, do you think Tyson will resort to roughhouse tactics?
You know, I think on the inside, he will try some roughhouse tactics. That's what he's supposed to do. Put some hurt on Evander Holyfield, wear him down. He has what appears to be a stronger body. Wear down Evander Holyfield.
Here comes Mike Tyson. The reaction is mixed, but mostly applause and cheering. The question is, in many minds, what will happen to Mike Tyson the first time he gets hit?
Well, you know, many times fighters do revert back to what comes natural to them, rolling and banging. But let's remember something. If they roll and bang and they get in that kind of fight, I think it's advantageous to Mike Tyson if Evander can revert into that type of fight himself.
I think one of the things we haven't covered is this eye cut. As a doctor, a fight doctor, I can tell you, it is no problem at all. It has plenty of time to heal. If it's cut again, it's just an accident, because that is not a factor in this fight.
Yes, I mentioned they say it's no consequence. We're standing by for the champion. And here he is, Evander Holyfield. And the crescendo from the sellout crowd builds. Demeanor the same.
You know what? He's confident. He's very religious. He's sold. He knows he did what he had to do. There's nothing left in his mind that he has to do.
I said, I see you ready. Put your hands together. Come on.
The spirit of the Lord upon my heart. I will dance like a man dance.
crowd explodes. No matter what happens tonight, Holyfield's name secure in boxing history for what he did in the first meeting. Now he tries to punctuate it. Both principals are in the ring. Let's run down the figures as we go to the tail of the tape, brought to you by The Ring Magazine, the Bible of boxing. As you can see, Holyfield older, taller, with a big reach advantage. Tyson turns 31 in a couple of days. Holyfield 3 pounds over the first fight, his highest weight. Tyson 4 pounds less than the first meeting. Both well sculpted. WBA rules for this title fight. The key rules, no standing 8 count. 3 knockdown rule is in effect. Only the referee can stop the fight. A fighter cannot be saved by the bell except in the final round. If an accidental foul occurs before the end of the fourth round, the fight is declared a technical draw. If it happens after the end of the fourth, they go to the cards. So here at the MGM Grand Garden in Las Vegas, set for the official introductions, we go up to our ring announcer, the classy Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we present the action in our main event of the evening, at this time we ask you to rise for the singing of our national anthem. In the spirit of tonight's dedication, in celebrating the triumph of human spirit, let us, in our national anthem, present to you at this time our leader, one of the success stories and adopted daughters of Hale House, the Harlem program for children of drug-abused parents. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please welcome to the microphone the talented vocalist to lead us, Mika Hale.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars
and King Vision, in association with Showtime Event Television, the MGM Grand and Gold Premium Beer. This bout coming away is sanctioned and directed under the auspices of the World Boxing Association, President Gilberto Mendoza, representing the WBA, Dr. Elias Cordova, Supervisor Leonard Nipper Reed, along with the Nevada State Athletic Commission. The chairman is Dr. Elias Ghanem, Commissioner commissioners, Nat Carasalli, Lorenzo Fertitta, Luther Mack, and Dr. James Nave. The executive director, Mark Ratner. Physicians at ringside, we have Drs. Flip Omansky, James Game, Al Capanna, and Robert Voy. Timekeepers at the bell, also keeping count of the knockdowns, Jane Broadfoot and James Cavan, and our judges scoring this bout from ringside, who will determine the outcome should we go to a decision, Dwayne Ford, Chuck Jumpa, and Jerry Roth. All right, fans, here we go. The time has come. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, it is showtime. With the WBA Heavyweight Championship of the World scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. Introducing to you our referee in charge of this bout, the third man in the ring working in this, his 96th world title bout, Mills Lane. Presenting to you first, ladies and gentlemen, the challenger on my left, fighting out of the blue corner, entering the ring wearing his traditional black trunks and hailing from Catskill, New York. He weighed in at a ready 218 pounds with a record of 45 wins, 2 losses. He has 39 big wins coming by way of knockout. The youngest man ever to win the heavyweight title. He is looking to exact his revenge and regain his championship. Tonight, challenging for his third heavyweight crown, here is the current WBA number one contender, one of the great powers of heavyweight history, the former undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, ladies and gentlemen, introducing Iron Mike Tyson. Opponent across the ring in the red corner, presenting the defending world champion, wearing purple trunks with white trim, fighting out of and representing his hometown of Atlanta, Georgia. He weighed in the same weight as his opponent, 218 pounds, with a record of 33 wins, 3 losses. He has 24 wins coming by way of knockout. Please welcome only the second man in history to have captured the heavyweight crown 3 times, the former undisputed cruiserweight world champion, the former undisputed heavyweight world champion. Ladies and gentlemen, here is boxing's warrior spirit, the current WBA heavyweight champion of the world, introducing Evander, the real deal. Once again, our referee in charge, Mills Lane, now to give instructions.
Brace off, Richard. Take the brace off the side. Okay, that's fine. Okay, now, gentlemen, we've gone through all the instructions in the dressing room. Okay, step back, Richie. Now, look here. Right here. If he goes right here, I'm not going to call it low, okay? If he goes right here, I'm not going to call it low. Now, I expect a tough, clean fight. Protect yourself at all times. Any questions from the challenger? Chief Second. Any questions from the champion, Chief Second? Let's get it on!
The waiting is over. The talking is done. The rematch is here. Evander Holyfield, confident, relaxed, cool. He says he doesn't look for the Tyson he fought November 9th. He thinks Tyson will be more aggressive, which he feels plays into his hands. Mike Tyson predicting a sensational victory. The sense of anticipation as before the first fight is almost palpable. Here we go, fight 2, round 1. A straight right by Mike Tyson, shrugged off by Evander Holyfield.
Mike came in with the same thing, 1-2, looking to go over the jab.
And a lot of movement by Tyson, which we did not see in the first fight.
Al Jaquetti said he's going to be bobbing, weaving. He's going to be jabbing. Well, he certainly started out jabbing and then throwing it right afterwards. So let's see if we see improvement in the offense of Mike Tyson.
I think you can sense the amount of respect here, too, by both fighters.
And some wrestling tactics as they come together. Look at the look on Tyson's face as he goes eye to eye with Holyfield, Mills Lane. A wild swing and a miss with an overhand right by Tyson.
It's interesting to see who's going to push who back. Jaquetti said, I'm going to let this guy get pushed back.
Branched off the side of Holyfield's head, an overhand right by Tyson.
You know what Mike's doing? Mike's looking to duck and keep his leverage low and come up banging. I notice he doesn't want to go backwards. And Evander right now is picking his spots, but he's looking for something.
Mills Lane jumping in there, trying not to have Holyfield clutch and grab.
But Holyfield's coming in low. That last time he was standing straight up. Now when he rushes in, he's rushing in low, so you can't just grab him. See that little waltz? Now who went backwards? Evander Holyfield went backwards.
In the first fight, it was Tyson going backwards, and he can't fight that way. Left hooks by Evander Holyfield. Measuring Tyson out now with the left jab. Looking to set up the right. There it is. Right on the top of
Evander Holyfield's trying to play that strategy too, Steve. He's trying to push Mike back, starting it right now, setting the tone.
Come on, hit.
Under a minute remaining in the opening round.
Right there, when Mike goes to come in, Evander ties him up. Mike cannot allow it. He's got to have some punches being on the way. They have to be en route before he gets that close.
Tyson to the left hook to the head of Holyfield.
He hurt Mike really good with that right hand. I'll tell you what, though. Mike hit him back with the left hook. This is going to be a war.
What a first round.
He was in trouble there. He shook Tyson. He shook him.
Straight left by Holyfield.
Come on.
The chance at Holyfield start early. They started in the sixth round of the first.
Jab. So you're stiff jabbing, good. I want you now jab for the throat. Jabbing for the throat. You're moving good. Keep off the center. Keep moving and punch. You got to punch. Don't wait on him.
Take a look at how Tyson got in trouble. Whang! They went that punch. That wasn't the one that got him in trouble. That wasn't the clear punch that got him in trouble. There's a punch to the side that's not much. And again, the struggle. Let's look at it again, Bobby.
You'll see a right hand a little later in the round. There's the right hand. That's the one that got him trouble. Right in the button, and he got Mike on his heels. Got him on his heels. Mike's not going forward.
Yeah. Bad intentions on the punches from both fighters in round one from the very first second.
Evander Holyfield makes his point in the first round.
Yeah, and he looks much more confident in the way he punches. He almost has the confidence. I'm going to hit this guy when I want to, and then it's going to hurt him. I wonder what that did to Tyson's confidence.
Holyfield picking up where he left off with the crowd behind him. 220 at his best combination. Again, more head movement from Tyson. Something we didn't see in the first fight. He looks over to Mills Lane. There's a cut around the right eye of Mike Tyson from a clash of heads, I believe.
That's just what happened. And Mike said, what about this buddy? What about this head?
That's a butt.
Deja vu.
Cuts the butt. Here we go. Time in, let's go.
Look at the blood streaking down from the outer portions of the right eye of Tyson.
What a terrible thing, and what an anticlimactic way to have this fight unfold.
Well, it should spur Tyson to a big effort.
It's the same eye that was cut while he was sparring that postponed the rematch date of May 3rd. But We're not sure if it's the exact same cut that reopened.
Well, one thing is different. He has now got pressure on him and he's just started this fight.
And again, just like in the first fight, Tyson looks over for help from the referee.
I think he was complaining about a low blow there. I didn't see a blow go south of the border, but that's what he's complaining about, I think.
And there's Amanda Holyfield mauling and pushing him around to the ropes.
If an accidental foul occurs before the end of the fourth round, the fighters ruled a technical draw. After the end of the fourth, they go to the cards. Holyfield digging in with uppercuts to the body, now going upstairs, looking for the cut.
Evander is beating Mike to the punch and he's making Mike pay. When Mike comes in, he smothers his shots and he counters well, and Mike doesn't counter the counter.
What Mike is doing, though, is at least he's crouching down a lot more than he did before, and those punches are going over where they were landing last time.
And that cut over the right eye is fairly deep. I just got a pretty good glance at it. Pushing into the ropes by Holyfield.
Holyfield showing he's stronger. Again, he's pushing him around like a rag doll. That's not good.
Hey, don't touch him. Come here. You know better than that. All right? Let's go. Come on.
Mills Lane taking charge. Over the top.
Mike throwing a nice right hand, but you see he's not following up with the big combination. It's got to be two and three. It can't be one at a time, Steve. That's not the way to get this one done.
And Tyson really beginning to look frustrated now as they continue to dance around, holding on to one another.
That one punch at a time, Bob, you referred to, just happened right then again. If he doesn't do better than that, this is going to be the same thing as the last time.
Don't forget Tyson with a plastic surgeon in his corner. And he's going to need it.
You see Evander coming in, and the head just winds up slamming into Mike's eye, and unfortunately, it's a cut already. Wasn't a big deal, but I'm sure he didn't mean it. But his head was down. Another look at it, Evander just kind of dives. There it is, right there. Puts his head down and comes straight in, and hits Mike right in the corner of his right eye.
Bad luck.
Dr. Ira Trocky telling Tyson he's fine, but that may be wishful thinking. But before the bell for round three, Tyson comes out fast but forgot his mouthpiece.
He's anxious to get this on. I think he's blown the first two rounds, and he better get started.
Round two, very bad for Tyson with that bad cut. Pushed away by Holyfield. Again, showing his strength. A sense of urgency here by Tyson.
And that's the old Tyson we know.
That's the Mike Tyson that came. That's the Mike Tyson that needed to come.
A ferocious Mike Tyson, bobbing and weaving.
If he can keep that up for the whole round, he can even this thing out as far as intentions. He's got to show he's got it. He's got to bring it.
He has to reverse what's going on here. Momentum still with Evander.
And the crowd really picking up now.
I don't step back. Come on, let him go, Mike. Come on.
A frantic pace. Listen. The crowd is turning. Many yelling Tyson. A swing and a miss with a straight right by Holyfield. Good duck under move by Tyson.
But Tyson's still throwing more right hands than he's normally used to doing over the top. He has seen something in the tapes. It's not effective yet, but he is working on it.
Will we see his lethal left hook soon? Mike Tyson. A lot of wrestling early in round three.
Nice right hand by Mike. He is trying to get that right hand home.
They seemingly are relying on one big shot.
There you see Evander put that arm around Mike's left hook arm again, walking him off. Doesn't want to get hit with that bomb on the inside.
Oh, a low blow by Holyfield with the left hook, and Mills Lane gives him an earful. Back comes Tyson.
on the belt. Tyson with a short left hook to the head of Holyfield. A right hand by Mike Tyson to the head of Holyfield, a straight right.
The left hook got his attention, then he came back with a nice 1-2, a left hook and a right hand, and Holyfield looked like he was stunned.
But what a chin by Holyfield.
Good stiff jab.
That's the jab Mike didn't have in the first fight.
What happened here?
He got bit, I think.
Evander Holyfield, look out, he's pushed right here, above us by Tyson.
He's got bit in the ear.
Oh my goodness, he's got a bloody right ear. Holyfield bit by a dirty Mike Tyson.
I can't believe what I'm seeing.
Well, first he had a parachute drop on him, now he had a heavyweight behind him.
When did we get that on tape?
Biting Holyfield in the right ear. What a reaction.
Well, and he certainly, that hurts like hell, but he certainly had a big bite. And it's a dangerous bite.
Oh, disgusting tactics here by Mike Tyson. Understand, 1 point has been deducted from Tyson for that vicious exhibition.
Now they could disqualify him, but they've taken a point, that's for sure. Oh, here comes the commissioner now. They got to figure it out.
Well, this is the doctor and the commissioner. Both
he
they can look at.
He bit his ear. He's out. He bit his ear. I can see the bite marks.
Okay. He bit his ear. He's out.
Telling Mark Ratner, head of the commission.
Well, let me ask the doc. He bit his ear. Can you go on?
Yes.
Okay. It's going to be a 2-point deduction. The fight will go on. 2 point.
Mills Lane was ready to stop the fight for Holyfield.
The fight will go on.
Overruled by Flip Pomansky, the doctor, who said
Mills Lane is a take charge kind of guy. He's a judge.
He bit
him. He'll take no nonsense.
It's bullshit. It's going to cost him 2 points. 2 points. 2 points off here. He bit his ear. 2 points off. Two.
Can you believe this?
This is getting stranger and stranger. We're getting to see strange things happen in boxing.
He should be disqualified today.
We go back to the change of referees.
I wonder how this would have played in Mitch Halpern's eyes.
Oh, my goodness.
That's a thought, Bobby. You got a big, tough judge here.
Major controversy here in round three. A very angry Evander Holyfield now. A left hook.
You know, it's funny, Mike was having his best
round. He bit him again.
Mike Tyson has bitten Evander Holyfield for the second time, and it is all out war.
I saw that one. That was right clear. It's a miracle he didn't get bit back.
I'll tell you what, this is unbelievable.
Let's take two looks at that one, at that bite. Now here's a bite. Keep your eye on Mike. See, Mike has just, see, look at him. You can see it. You can see it. There it is.
I can't believe what I'm seeing, fellas.
Bobby.
They're going in real slow motion. Mike gets in a headlock. And look at this. He just reaches in and bites him.
It's over. During that replay.
That's it. I'm gone.
I've got Mills Lane.
Mills Lane signaling that it's over. I think they've just about had enough. Tyson showing desperation in biting Holyfield two times. Look out now. More fighting in the ring after the end of the fight. Tyson's trying to get at Holyfield again, I believe. It is complete bedlam, and Tyson is just taking swipes at anybody in front of him.
The police are coming in by the squad here, and they're still fighting in there.
It's a fiasco in the ring. People are jumping above us. trying to get in there. There's the security trying to hold Tyson back.
This is the most unbelievable spectacle I have ever seen. The first one was an amazing feat. The second one is disastrous.
It's just impossible to conceive.
Tyson's bodyguard fighting with the security. The crowd in stunned disbelief here.
I'm beginning more and more to believe Tyson is a confused individual. He is
I think
a
it goes beyond confused, Ferdy. I think
individual.
It goes beyond confused. I can't understand it. Mike was having his best round. He was getting Dave Ander. He hit him with some great shots. The right hand got through the hook. Don't know what happened. Let's take a look at the second bite. Now he'd already bitten the man once.
It's impossible to believe this happened again, but it did. Just keep your eyes on Mike's mouth as much as you can, because you will see it. Now you see he's got his hand, he's got it right there. He's got his mouth on it. See it? See it? It's a shark bite right there. That is incredible. Look at the reaction again from Holyfield. He can't believe it. He got the second one on the other side.
You know what? If I were Vander, I would have kicked him. I don't know what held him back.
Let's look
at it again.
Bobby.
Watch Mike. Come inside. This is the second bite of the round. Right on Evander's ear.
It's like Dracula time. I've never seen anything like this in boxing.
I can't understand it. I'm sure there will be suspensions and bans galore.
What a wild scene here at the MGM Grand. Just a shame that it has to come to a conclusion in this fashion. Mike Tyson resorting to biting tactics. And he still wants more as he's being held back by Richie Giacchetti. Just an awful display here by Tyson.
I'm nothing short of shocked, Steve. I am speechless. I have no response for what I've just witnessed.
Mike Tyson has apparently lost his reason, his rationale. He seems possessed right now. He cannot be brought under control. It is just bedlam above us. People stepping on our table trying to break into the clear. You can see, of course, what's going on in the ring.
Mike is still being restrained.
Has Holyfield been ushered out of the ring? I can't even see him.
Holyfield just came past us, Steve. He is out of the ring. He is clear.
Let's go over to Jim Gray.
All right. Thank you very much, Steve Albert. Steve, thank you very much. I have Mills Lane. Mills, why did you stop the fight? Because of the first bite on the ear or the second?
The second one. The first one was a foul. I took 2 points. The doctor said he could continue. So I let it continue. And he beat him on the other ear. I told him, I said, one more time like that, it's it. You're gone. I told him both. Knocked the rough stuff off. And he bit him again. I said, that's it. You're gone.
As Holyfield leaves the ring, the condition of the ear, could he have continued? And did you disqualify him because of the foul or because he couldn't continue?
Oh, no. I disqualified Tyson for the second foul. I told him, do not do that again. You do, you're gone.
So he could have continued. The physical condition of Evander Holyfield was such of you that he could have continued had he not disqualified Tyson.
Well, I didn't ask the doctor. I never reached that point. I wasn't going to ask the doctor. That wasn't a question. That kind of foul, I mean, you got to take a position sometime, somewhere. That was it.
Pandemonium breaking out here as Mike Tyson is leaving the ring, and we'll continue with Mills Lang. As you see, people getting knocked over. Our camera goes down. Mills, let me continue here. Mike Tyson's people and Tyson are going to say, I'm sure you didn't call a foul on the headbutt, which caused the eye, and this could have been a retaliation by Tyson.
I called it a butt.
But you didn't take a point.
An unintentional butt, you don't take a point. An unintentional butt, unless it's occurred the second time. An unintentional butt, if he fights stop, you go to the scorecards after 4 rounds. There's a difference between an unintentional butt and a bite.
Do you feel as though that's what Tyson was doing, however, that he was retaliating?
I do not know. You'll have to ask him. I don't speculate. I do not know the answer to that.
Obviously, disappointment, Mills. Got to be disappointing for you to have it come to a conclusion like this as well.
You know, you play the hand you dealt and do the best you can with the cards. That's all I can tell you.
All right, Mills Lane, thank you for your time. Let's send it back now to Steve Albert.
Thank you,
Jim.
You
want me to go in the locker room?
We're trying to get an interview with Evander Holyfield. Love to hear his reaction. Why should Holyfield even ever have to fight Tyson again after this terrible display by Mike Tyson?
Steve, it's unbelievable. I don't believe Evander would ever sign to fight Mike again. I don't think that it would be an issue any longer. It's not about the fight. It's just about it being real personal. That's beyond boxing.
This crowd still stunned. Everybody just standing around in disbelief. Holyfield never even had a chance to prove that the first fight was no fluke.
Will the people pay to see Mike Tyson fight again? Will they support him through this? This is the most amazing thing I've ever seen, Steve.
He just totally lost all reason.
You know, fighting's a very, very, very difficult game, not just physically, but mentally and emotionally. And we saw what happened to Oliver McCall some time ago. He just temporarily snapped, and evidently Mike has for a little bit here himself.
Evander Holyfield defends his title in most unorthodox fashion. People still milling around after this debacle. In round three, referee Mills Lane deducted 2 points for that intentional foul. And then he stopped the fight after the second biting attack by Mike Tyson. We're still trying to get back there to get Evander Holyfield, but it's a terrible scene here because several of our camera people have been knocked around like rag dolls, their equipment damaged. And so we're trying to recuperate, regroup, and try to get some equipment and a person back there. Oh, we understand now. Ferdy Pacheco is ready with Evander Holyfield.
Go ahead. All right, Evander Holyfield, 2 bites on each side, 1 piece is missing out of your plastic surgeon said. Your reaction?
Well, first of all, I had to give praise to the Lord. You know, Jesus, Lord, you know, I'm still the champion. You still get the glory. And, you know, the things that happened, it didn't have to happen. You know, I was beating him, and, you know, he spit out of my mouth, he just bit me in the ear.
Is that the act of a crazed man? Because to beat you twice, I mean, to bite you twice is a little crazy.
Well, you know, the whole thing is that, you know, in the first one, you know, my corner, you know, told me to just keep cool. And, I thought about that, you know, a distraction would happen, and his prophecies told me to, just breathe deep and just concentrate on Jesus. Then I went back out there again, and I caught him with good shots, and he bit my ear on purpose again.
But how can he bite your ear with a mouthpiece? Spit it out of the mouth?
He spit the mouthpiece out. He spit the mouthpiece out and bit me on the ear on the last time. You know, the whole thing is that, you know, really, his only chance that he thought he could is just to go. My whole thing is that, you know, the whole thing is my ear bleeding, and this guy continued to foul. You know, I'm thankful that we have a referee like Mill Lane see the situation that this thing is intention. And, you know, it's just amazing when...
Would this rule out a rematch? It's stupid to ask you right now for a rematch. This guy went and lost his marbles. Is a rematch possible, or are you so mad you wouldn't even think about that?
Well, you know, the whole thing is that, you know, I have to concentrate and I have to think, you know, I have to think about the situation. Because the big thing is to you know, a rules and regulation, mandatory things. But the rules, you got to understand when a person deliberately bites you, constantly and trying to break my arm, because you know in the corner he's just doing illegal tactics. You know, Mill Lane said, you know, break. You know, the whole thing is that there's just an easy way to get out of the fight, the foul, because you know you're gonna get disqualified still fighting through. I'm saying that don't show no courage whatsoever. Everybody know how to get out of the fight. All you got to do is foul, you'll get yourself out. Then you can say, well, he didn't beat me.
Would you say this is the act of a desperate man? Would you say he was desperate in there? Is that the word, you think, to cause a guy to do something so unusual?
Well, the whole thing is that, you know, I truly believe that fear itself calls people to do the easiest thing, the quickest thing to get out. I'm saying the whole thing is that we're in a fight already, so why do you have to bite somebody? If you feel that you can whoop me, why you can't whoop me with the gloves on? This is a boxing match. This is not a... a rumble. And when the fight is over, then you get brave and you really want to fight. I'm saying, you had a chance to fight. You know, why you got to bite me on my ear? The whole thing is that, it's not real. You know, my whole thing is that I just give praise to the Lord that it is not worse than it is. I thought my ear had fell off.
Well, your plastic surgeon here says a piece is missing out of your ear, which means you'll have to have a plastic repair. And either ear, since human bites are so dangerous, have to be taken care of tonight at the hospital.
I look forward to going to the hospital. Good thing I got a doctor.
All right. Good. I mean, remarkable. Let's go to Gray.
All right. Thank you, Ferdy. We are outside of Mike Tyson's locker room. There is utter pandemonium going on here. Finally, a little bit of some quiet. John Horn, the co-manager of Mike Tyson, joins us right now. John, this is a scene like we have never seen before. It was totally out of control. What is the situation inside of that locker room, and can you ascertain why Mike bit Evander?
Well, I'm not going to even comment on that until I see what really happened, but all I know is this. Evander has been headbutting Mike for two fights. Headbutting is a foul, a complete foul, but it's been happening so often, so long, that when a person headbutts another person, cuts both of their eyes, it becomes a common thing, and it's okay to let that go.
Was this a retaliation?
No, it turned into, Evander turned it into a street fight a long time ago. A long time ago. And I'm not going to even get off into it until I understand everything and see what happened. And all I know is Mike got a cut over his eye, 3 inches long. Evander got a little nip on his ear that don't mean nothing.
Mike
and
wanted
the bottom
to
line, he jumped around like a little bitch. That's what he did. Okay, now Mike didn't do nothing. Mike didn't complain. He didn't say nothing. He didn't ask the man to stop the fight. Because headbutt's been going on so long, it's okay, but it's a foul.
You can't bite anybody, regardless.
I didn't say he bit nobody. I said when I look at everything, we'll determine.
Well, it's very clear.
Mike got a 3-inch cut over his eye.
That's
not from a punch. Okay, so therefore, what can I say?
One is accidental, and it appears.
No, come
as
on, please. One headbutt may be accidental. 15 is not.
What would you have liked to have seen done by Mills Lane? This was the referee
like
of your choice.
I would like to see him let the fight go. The air ain't got nothing to do with his fight.
He got a little cut on the ear, man.
The air ain't got nothing to do with the fight. Ain't got nothing to do with his arms, his legs, his hand, his body, nothing.
You don't need to scream at me.
Mike got a cut over his eye.
Okay.
Mike got a 3-inch cut over his eye that the blood will penetrate to his eye, blur his vision, and everything. Now, I understand
Mills Lane, let me clarify it for you, since you don't know what Mills Lane has said to us. Mills Lane said he didn't disqualify him for the first bite because he was willing to let that go with a 2-point deduction. The second bite, however, at the end of the round is what he said he had just had enough.
Well, I have to see everything involved first. I can't comment on no bite or whatever the case may be. All I know is Mike got a 3-inch gash over
his eye. Are you unhappy with the referee, Mills Lane?
Not at all.
Okay.
Has nothing. No, not at all. I'm unhappy with all the headbutts and stuff for two fights. Mike done been cut 4 times by this guy, neither time by a punch. Now you tell me what that is. That's all I know. Everything else I'm going to have to see about, I'm going to have to go over. I don't know nothing about that. But he turned into a street fight long time ago.
The tapes clearly show that I'm being told in the first fight that Mike caused the butts, and that was ascertained. In this one, it was an accidental butt, although it appeared, what would you have liked to have seen done at that moment? It's too late after the fact to bite somebody. What would you have liked to have seen at that time?
All I know is this. There was nothing wrong with Evander Holyfield that would have kept him from performing. That's all I know.
Okay.
So I can't comment on that.
But you're not unhappy with the referee. This was your referee.
No, I'm not unhappy because I don't even know all the terms yet. Everything happened so quickly, I don't even know all the conditions. All I know is my fighter got a 3-inch cut over his eye.
Okay. Can we talk to Mike Tyson?
No, not right now. Mike has a 3-inch cut he has to take care of. Thank you very much.
Okay, John. Don King. Obviously, not the way that anybody expected that this was going to go. Very disappointing to everybody who bought the fight and those in attendance here. Your thoughts on this disqualification?
Well, I think that the headbutts was there, and I think that when he had the headbutts, and as he had headbutts prior to that, it should have been some type of a point taken away or something to acknowledge these headbutts, because this was said so and priorly before the fight started, to watch the headbutts. You know what I mean? And so it's very difficult when two athletes are fighting, you know what I mean, and things can happen, but these headbutts seemingly...
Don, but the fact of the matter is the headbutts, yes, it is a problem. Everybody will acknowledge that Holyfield was in violation with the headbutts. The proper reaction, however, is not to bite, correct?
Well, the proper reaction is not to bite, you know what I mean? But I guess when a guy feels that he's pleading with the referee to give him some consideration and he don't get the consideration, then he just goes beyond reason. I mean, you must be able to deal with reason and practicality, but you got two athletes in there, highly passionate, very hot, ready to fight, and fight they were doing. The fight was just beginning. I don't know why it was, would be stopped.
What? Well, because Holyfield, it was determined by Mills Lane. Let me stop you right there before we go on to that. You're saying Mills Lane should not have stopped the fight on the second fight?
No. When Holyfield got bitten, Mills Lane said he took a point from Mike Tyson.
Then a second point.
And what of the second point?
And then at the end of the round, Mills Lane has said that Tyson bit him on the other ear, which in this instance I believe would be the left ear. Two bites on the ear.
I didn't see it, so I can't comment on
that's
that.
That's why he disqualified him.
Well, I don't know. I'd have to see that before I make any comments. I don't want to be irrational.
Okay, let's move on. Where does this leave Mike Tyson in his career, and will there be a third bout between these two, and do you think you could ever put anything like that together?
Well, I want to find out first the facts, and then after you find out the facts, you see what you can do. I think that when a fighter like Mike Tyson or Holyfield find that they're being wrong and they're not getting the consideration that they think they should have, then they try to take it in their own hands, and that's not always the right thing to do. Uh-huh. But nevertheless, that's what's been done when you have people out there that's in this type of atmosphere and climate, and it looked like they were just beginning to fight.
Could you ever, do you feel, convince Holyfield to take this fight again?
I don't know. I don't know whether I can or not until we find out what all of the evidence is and find out what is happening, what actually happened. You know what I mean? I'm just like a fan as anyone else at this particular time.
It'd be a terrible disappointment if there wasn't another, correct?
Yeah, it certainly would be, because these guys certainly don't prove that they're two good athletes, but they got to be able to fight, and they want to fight, and it looked like that's what they were doing. I didn't know. I thought after the points was taken, that was the punishment meted out for whatever the error was in Mike Tyson. What happened after that, I don't know, because when he sat down, the bell rang, they went to their corners. I thought they was coming back out to fight, and all of a sudden, it was a DQ.
I know you don't make this decision, but should these fighters be paid for this evening's work? There's some 60-some-odd million dollars who went out tonight, out of your pocket.
Yes, they should be paid. They came and they fought. You know what I mean? Boxing is unpredictable. You don't know what's going to happen in a boxing match. That's what makes it so great. But the fact of the matter is, well, I think we should first try to find out what happened before we start making judgment.
What do you say to the folks who bought the fight who are terribly disappointed who are watching this right now?
I'm disappointed myself because of the outcome. I want to see this fight go to the finale. You know what I mean? This was the Sound and the Fury. It was something that everybody purported and recognized as going to be a great event. And then here comes the headbutts, and then here comes the retaliation for the headbutts. But after you get taken the points from the man, I just think that they should have been able to fight. If you get a headbutt or a low blow, you get 5 minutes to recuperate. I think it should have took another step to say, give him 5 minutes to recuperate or something to let these people get their money's worth and be able to deal with this fight.
As the man in charge of this show, I got to put you on the spot right here. What will you do in the upcoming moments to make sure that we have a word with Mike Tyson before we leave the air?
Well, I'm going to do everything I can to talk to Mike Tyson, to let Mike Tyson tell his side of the story. I think it's only fair and proper that he should do that, and I would do everything I can to get him to do that. I also would like to get to talk to the commission and find out what their judgment is on a situation of this type. And when this has happened, after you take the points, to come back and take the fight too. I don't understand it, so maybe they can explain it to me.
Well, as you say, only in America, and only in America, Steve Albert, would we have seen something quite like this tonight. We hope to have Mike Tyson, Charlie. Back out to you.
All right, Jim. Mike Tyson disqualified for biting both ears of Evander Holyfield in the third round. Let's just clean up some business before we talk here at ringside on camera. The online scoring, Holyfield ahead 3-0 over Tyson. In actuality, all three judges had Holyfield winning the first two rounds here at ringside. Tyson won the third, but had 2 points deducted, and then the WBA heavyweight championship was halted. Steve Albert back with the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco and Bobby Chez, and I thought this was an inexcusable, despicable, illegal exhibition by Mike Tyson. What do you think, Ferdy?
I agree wholeheartedly. I think when you're hearing Don King trying to kind of make patch up, he didn't see the ears. I just came from examining his ears. One of them's got a chunk of flesh missing about a half inch off the crown. They're going to have to do plastic surgery, reconstruct that. It's out. It's a chunk of flesh out. That's not just a little bite. That is a wolf-like bite. I don't understand the second bite, and I understand why they disqualified him. I don't think anybody can make any justification or rationalization for something as bizarre as not one, but two bites. Something clicked inside of Mike's brain. We've been saying Mike Tyson's an unpredictable and confused young man. I don't think you can see any evidence of mental confusion and unpredictability more than we just saw there with a fighter biting another fighter in the same round two times and taking a chunk out of his ear. I think, end of the story, this guy is one confused individual.
I'll open this up to the both of you, Ferdy and Bobby. Perhaps construed as an extreme statement, but is Mike Tyson's career over?
I don't think so. I think his big aspiration to be considered one of the great heavyweights is gone. I don't care what he does, he's never going to be considered a great heavyweight. That he can fight and continue, yes. Okay, let's see right. If we can get
you're
Tyson.
Hearing what I'm hearing. We've got Mike Tyson available for an interview right now. Let's go back over to Jim Gray.
All right, thank you, Steve. I'm now joined by Mike Tyson. Mike, first of all, let's go in chronological order. The headbutt in the second round, which opened the gash on your eye. Tell us about that first, please.
He butted me in the first round, but then he butted me again in the second round. Then as soon as he butted me, I watched him. He had me holding, and he looked right at me, and I saw him, and he kept going for mine, and he butted me again. He kept going down and coming up, and he charged into me. And no one warned him. No one took any points for him. What am I to do? This is my career. I can't continue getting butted like that. I got children to raise, and this guy keeps butting me, trying to cut me and get me stopped on cut. I got to retaliate.
Now, immediately, you stopped. You stopped fighting immediately right there, and you turned to Mills Lane and you said what? And the result was he did nothing. But what did you say to Mills right at that time?
I don't remember what I said. I told him that he butted me, but I know I complained about being butted. And we complained about the first fight. Listen, Holyfield is not the tough warrior everyone said he is. He got little nicks on him there and he quit. I got an eye. I got one eye. I got one eye. He's not impaired. He got ears. I got one eye. Big deal. If he take one, I got another one. I'm ready to fight. He didn't want to fight. I'm ready to fight him right now.
Mills Lane, though. Mills Lane stopped the fight. It wasn't Holyfield who stopped the
fight. Oh, he didn't want to fight. He didn't want to fight.
Let me ask.
We don't know what Mills did. Don't put nothing on Mills.
Well, Mills said he stopped the fight. You bit him. Was that a retaliation for the eye when you bit him in his ear?
Regardless of what I did, he been butting me for two fights.
But you got to address it, Mike. Why
did
you bite him?
No, I did address it. I addressed it in the ring.
Why did you do that, though, Mike? I mean, was that the proper response?
Look at me. I got to go home and my kids are going to be scared of me. Look at me, man.
What are you going to do now in terms of your career, Mike? Will you continue to fight?
Very much, Jim, for respect,
okay,
brother.
Okay. That's the story from back here. Let's send it back out to you, Steve.
Of course, they're not going to get on Mills Lane. They're the ones that triggered the change. But let me ask you this. Does a headbutt warrant this kind of ridiculous retaliation?
A headbutt is an unfortunate side effect of this game. Getting punched, getting cut, getting butted, getting elbowed. Certainly some are more blatant than others. Some are bad, and some people do it consistently. I don't believe Evander tried. I believe Evander tried to keep his head down so he didn't get it taken off with those big whistling hooks that Mike was throwing. You have to get under Mike's big shots or you'll get hurt. The fact that he got butted. But, I cannot find an excuse anywhere in my system for biting him the first time, let alone the second time. And if he wasn't disqualified the second time, it would be impossible to justify that fight went on.
We just saw the sound of the fury, but the loser.
We saw a lot of sound. We certainly saw a lot of fury, but we didn't see what we wanted to see.
Do you think Tyson's career is history?
You know, the only people that can decide that isn't actually even Mike Tyson. It's the people. If the people will still support Mike and come out to watch him fight, that's one thing. This may take a lot of people and really turn them off badly, Steve.
We want to take a look right now at some of the infighting. Take a look at some of the clashing of heads. Here we go.
Well, the main difference here is, as you were speaking, occurred to me, this is an unintentional, there you see it. This is an unintentional thing, right? But a bite is an intentional thing. You think about it and you go and bite somebody.
Ferdy, the fact of the matter is, a serious intentional blatant foul, you can be disqualified immediately. And here we'll see the first bite.
Now, watch.
The referee has every authority to disqualify you immediately on something this blatant.
Watch. Keep your eyes on Mike's mouth. That's where you're going to see the action. First, he's going to spit out the mouthpiece and then bite him. He didn't bite him with the mouthpiece. He wouldn't have caused that damage. The mouthpiece was bouncing on the floor about that time. In fact, it's over in Holyfield's corner right now.
I got news for you. The bottom of your teeth are not covered by the mouthpiece. He could have bit through with the bottom of teeth.
No,
very
no.
Clearly. I've been bit before in the ring with mouthpiece in and mouthpiece out.
But
it's
he
not
did
pleasant
spit it
at
in
all.
Front. He spit it in front of us, and they picked it up on the other side. It's the mouthpiece is right now in Holyfield's dressing room. It's in the pocket of one of the managers over there.
Unbelievable. Let's take a look at the final bite that caused the disqualification.
As if the first one wasn't bad enough, Mike goes and gets the other ear. What? Not one, but two.
See, this one is a minor one. The other one is a chunk of the ear out. If you photographed it, you wouldn't believe it right now. If somebody takes a picture of it, you won't believe what it looks like.
Great pictures, incidentally, from our camera people, our production crew. here at the MGM Grand.
I don't know what to say. I'm speechless, and I'm never speechless. I really don't know what to say.
I think it remains, to put it in perspective, a fighter who is possibly not the fighter he was before he went to prison. Now, he wasn't tested. Then Holyfield beat him. Then he was beating him again. Now he won two rounds, and he looked like he had the combination, and he didn't look like Mike Tyson of old. You know, we have never seen the Mike Tyson of old that was here before he went to prison. Since he came out, we have not seen that Mike Tyson. He fought easy fights, totally easy fights, and then when he got into a tough one, he lost it, got knocked out, and then he got into the tough one again, and he does this bizarre thing. When he was losing, he still had not look like Mike Tyson. So we don't know what Mike Tyson we've got here. We still don't know whether that's the same fury that we had it before he went to jail. Up to this point, I leave it to my colleague Bobby to give his opinion. I don't think that's the same Tyson, Bobby.
You know, he appeared to be the same Tyson when he fought Frank Bruno. He got back to moving the head, to banging the body, but Frank Bruno was so petrified, praying so hard before the fight, no one could tell he didn't offer to fight back. Bruce Seldon quit. Peter McNeely didn't count. Buster Mathis couldn't hurt him. So this was the first real man he faced. And unfortunately, the first time for Mike, he didn't make it through. He folded. And here, I can't even begin to tell you what he was thinking.
And after tonight, we may never see that Mike Tyson again.
That's my point. He may have left everything in prison, and he's never going to be the Mike Tyson we had. He's not that furious, destroy kind of animal. He was confused again. Again, he resorted to something incomprehensible to any sane man, so that we don't know where we're at with him. There's a lot of economic pressures, because he's got a big contract, and he's got Don King, and he's got everybody, and they will patch him back together, and we will see him fight again, because it's an economic necessity.
I've just been told that Evander Holyfield just went into an ambulance on his way to a hospital. So Holyfield wins by disqualification in the third round, a terrible display by Mike Tyson. That's it from ringside. Let's go back up to Jim Hill.
All right, Steve, thank you very much, as all of you are in shock, just as all of us are. And once again, I want to remind you that we will have an update on the Mike Tyson, Evander Holyfield situation coming up a little bit later on. And we will also talk with Sugar Ray Leonard, who touched me at the end of the first round and said Mike Tyson is in all kinds of trouble. We will talk to Sugar Ray Leonard about that. But as we promised you a little earlier this evening, we're going to have another bout coming up right now between Lonnie Bradley defending his WBO middleweight championship against John Williams. And we'll be back with Sugar Ray Leonard after that fight.
We are closing in on the WBO middleweight championship. Lonnie Bradley defending his title against John Williams. Bradley undefeated, but comes off his first blemish, a draw following 25 consecutive victories, hoping
just a couple of moments ago. And Elias Ghanem, who is the chairman of the Athletic Commission, had this remarkable announcement to make about Mike Tyson's purse.
My name is Dr. Ghanem. I'm the chairman of the Nevada State Athletic Commission. And pursuant to our Nevada revised statutes 467.156, Mike Tyson is temporarily suspended. His purse will be held pending a disciplinary hearing. The Nevada Athletic Commission will hold an emergency meeting at 10 o'clock July 1st, 1997, at the Las Vegas City Hall Council Chambers to review and discuss the events of this evening. The Nevada Athletic Commission will also consider formal disciplinary action against Mike Tyson at that time. If the Nevada Athletic Commission decides to proceed with a complaint against Mike Tyson, then he will be given not less than 30 days notice of the hearing pursuant to the Nevada Revised Statute 467.156 to appear in front of the commission. We'll be glad to answer any questions.
Meanwhile, Evander Holyfield was taken to the hospital for treatment of bites on both ears that he suffered in the third round against Mike Tyson. Evander Holyfield taken to a local hospital. And here's a look at Evander Holyfield, who is still the WBA heavyweight champion of the world, in this particular ambulance. And we can see him being taken to a local hospital, where we're told that his doctor, who is a plastic surgeon, says that there will have to be some kind of treatment. There is Evander right there, who is circled with the baseball cap on his head. Evander, after the fight said that he was still thankful to the Lord, and we can see that. We can see Sugar Ray, you can see Evander going out. And I'm just wondering right now, your thoughts on this bizarre evening.
Well, bizarre is an understatement. I think it was ridiculous. I think it was despicable, and I think it gives boxing another black eye. I don't know the explanation behind all this. The fans deserve better.
It's $30 million to each fighter, and Tyson's $30 million purse is going to be held pending further investigation.
Well, that's interesting, Jim. In fact, I think it's just weird. It really is. I mean, words can't describe what happened tonight.
I know in the first round you tapped me on the leg and you said Tyson is in trouble, but the look in your eye indicated to me that he was in more than just trouble in physically and just fighting in the ring tonight.
Well, the way he approached the ring, when he was in the ring, he didn't throw left jabs. He's very, I don't know, lethargic to me. He just wasn't in the fight. And again, he tried to land up one big punch.
Okay, Ray, thank you very much. And people will be talking about this for a long, long time. All right, my friends, let's go back and recap the five bouts on this very unusual night of boxing here in Las Vegas, Nevada. WBO middleweight king Lonnie Bradley defended his crown against John Williams.
Well, in fact, Bradley was just too much for John Williams. It was just a matter of time here. Here he threw all these punches, combinations. Williams was never in the fight.
So Bradley retains his title with an eighth round technical knockout. Moving on. Former lightweight champion Miguel Angel Gonzalez now campaigning as a super lightweight fought Bert Graziosa.
Well, Graziosa was just too little for Gonzalez. Gonzalez was just too experienced and just too strong. He put this man down and kept him down.
And Gonzalez wins with a TKO in the third round, and he looks forward now to a chance to go against Julio Cesar Chavez. Longtime rivals Christy Martin and Andrea DeShong met for the third time.
And this is what boxing is all about. Christy Martin displayed a beautiful left jab. She peppered DeShong the whole night.
And she retains her WBC Women's Lightweight Championship. Julio Cesar Chavez was in pursuit of his 100th career victory against Larry Lacossiere.
Well, he put his man down, but it was a very frustrating night for Chavez. He couldn't catch up with the marathon runner.
El Gran Campeón Mexicano gets career victory number 100. And in the main event, Holyfield versus Tyson, the rematch for the WBA Heavyweight Championship.
Well, here, once again, we see the bite that Tyson, I mean, this is crazy. This is unbelievable.
Holyfield was bitten on both ears, got pushed in the back there, bitten on both ears twice in the third round. Referee Mills Lane did not want to disqualify him after the first bite, but he did disqualify him after the second bite. And because of that, Mills Lane disqualified Mike Tyson, and Evander Holyfield retains his WBA Heavyweight Championship. So once again, let's take a look real quickly now at tonight's fight results. It is John Williams winning, Roberto Graziosa right there, winning Christy Martin. Martin going against Andrea DeShong. We talked about Julio Cesar Chavez gets career victory number 100, and Evander Holyfield retains his WBA Heavyweight Championship after Mike Tyson was disqualified. Wow, I guess that's about all we can say as well, huh?
What a night, Jim.
What a night is absolutely correct. You think they'll ever meet again, or should they ever meet again?
I doubt very seriously. The fans will not support that.
Okay, Ray, thank you so much for being with us, and thank you for joining us. It was a pleasure working with Sugar Ray Leonard, and for all of us here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena at the MGM Grand Hotel Casino and Theme Park, this is Jim Hill saying goodbye from Las Vegas. This has been a presentation of King Vision Pay-Per-View Limited Showtime Event Television. King Vision Executive Producer, Don King.
This has been a promotion of Don King Productions in association with the MGM Grand Hotel and Casino. Brought to you by Gold Premium Beer. Pay-Per-View distributed by Showtime Event Television.